actionfiguresource.com. Yesterday's toys, today's treasures.
The AC Gilbert Company was a very brief but significant contributor to action figure history. The story of its founder, Alfred Carlton Gilbert, is even more remarkable and fascinating. Born in 1884, Alfred took a particular interest in both science and sport, financing his degree in sports medicine at Yale by working as a magician. He set the world record for chin-ups and running long dive, and invented the pole vault. In 1907, Gilbert founded Mysto Manufacturing, which would later become the AC Gilbert Company. They started off primarily making magic sets, but branched out into chemistry, microscopes, astronomy playsets, and other educational toys. In 1913, Gilbert invented a toy named Erector, which was and remains to this day a Meccano-style construction set inspired by New York's railroad. In 1918, with America heavily embroiled in World War I, the Council of National Defense were considering a ban on toy production, most likely to redirect manufacture to military ordnance, which is always an immensely costly process. Gilbert successfully lobbied to have this repealed, earning him the nickname, "The Man Who Saved Christmas." 84 years later, a movie by this name was made about him, starring Seinfeld's Jason Alexander. It is interesting to imagine how the toy industry would have developed had Gilbert not been around, but his company still had some significant impact to make. In 1938, Gilbert acquired the rights to the American Flyer Model Railway and adopted the 3/16 scale. Gilbert's focus was on detail and making the trains seem more like miniature models than toys. Alfred's interest remained clearly in the real and the scientific. Alfred co-founded and became the first president of the Toy Manufacturers of America and introduced benefits for his employees. He also opened the Gilbert Hall of Science in New York City, which not only promoted invention and the discipline of science to children, but also sold his products. Possibly most bizarrely of all, in 1950, Gilbert released the U-238 Atomic Energy Laboratory. This retailed at the modern-day equivalent of $460. And contained an electroscope, a Wilson cloud chamber, a Geiger counter, and uranium. In 1954, at the age of 70, Alfred turned the company over to his son. He died 7 years later, and the family sold their shares to Jack Rather. The next 6 years, from 1961 until 1967, was the key development period in the Gilbert Company's impact on action figures. In an unusual move for the day, they acquired the license to produce toys based on the James Bond films. There was a James Bond slot racing set, a gadget-filled Aston Martin toy very similar to the well-known Corgi Classic, a line of 3-inch non-posable figures, followed by two that were the 12-inch G.I. Joe size, billed as action figures rather than as dolls. One of the figures was Bond himself, who came with a Thunderball-style diver's outfit. The other was Oddjob, who came in a karate gi. The more obvious smart suits that the characters wore in their cinematic experiences were most likely too complicated and expensive to manufacture, or possibly considered not conducive to action. Bond could fight Oddjob in his flippers, possibly underwater where the henchman's deadly hat attacks would be ineffective. Continuing the espionage theme, two more licenses were also garnered as a result of Bond, namely The Man from U.N.C.L.E. and the largely forgotten Honey West, the TV Private Eiffel. Napoleon Solo and Ilya Kuryakin were fortunately kitted out in more appropriate attire, and the clothes and accessories on all of these figures were interchangeable. It is in fact possible that had the popularity of these maintained, that Gilbert would have ended up closer to Mego, or with the introduction of Moon McDare Action Man from Space, complete with his spacesuited dog, they may possibly have had the market clout of G.I. Joe, which was produced by Hasbro around the same time. It was not to be, and by 1967 the company had folded, its assets divided up among other manufacturers. Looking at their output, either the market wasn't ready for them, or there was some mismanagement going on in the background, because the concepts that these figures were released under are very much the recipes for success that various other companies experienced in the following decades. AC Gilbert stands as an important, if mostly forgotten, early step in the action figure timeline, also as a testament to the creative drive that can be generated by one ambitious and inventive figurehead, and what happens when that determination is not carried forward to the next generation. Erector is still sold in the United States by Meccano.
ActionFigureResource.com. Yesterday's toys, today's treasures.